The dramatic scenes at Parliament buildings yesterday, after some opposition MPs were thrown out of the National Assembly for attempting to disrupt President Uhuru Kenyatta's State of the Nation address to Parliament. And today, court leader Raila Odinga supported the MPs' actions, saying National Assembly Speaker Justin Muturi was to blame for being high-handed.
They know what the people of Kenya feel, and therefore they have a right to go and raise those issues in Parliament. And if the Speaker had allowed debate, maybe certain issues would have come up. This is very normal. I don't know why the Speaker would refuse to allow honourable members to raise a point of order.
Muturi yesterday invoked standing orders in stopping the MPs from commenting or raising questions when the President was making a State of the Nation address.
This is a special sitting. I have just read out the convocation. When delivering an address to the House, the President shall be heard in silence, and the address shall not be followed by any comment or question.
Awe jamaa ingine amezirai ajali ya mtu gani ambaye anazungumza wakati huo hata kama awe ni rais rais si Mungu anakaa chini kidogo ili inajulikane isikike na julikane hivi jamaa ni kitu gani ambaye inamsumbua.
And according to the opposition leader, yesterday's whistling and jeering in Parliament points to a larger plan.
Firimbi ilipigwa katika bunge, hiyo ilikuwa ni kama firimbi ya kuamsha wa Kenya, kuambia wa Kenya kumepambauka, kumekucha, jogoo shawika mara tatu.
The Jubilee Coalition has termed yesterday's drama as disgraceful and a lack of decorum. President Kenyatta called for sober criticism.
Criticism without alternatives is just reckless political sport.
It remains to be seen what impact the drama witnessed yesterday will have on the country's political scene, even as Parliament plans to take punitive action on errant members.
Who are you?
Hussein Mohammed, Citizen Weekend.